is the gentlewoman from Washington.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I rise to offer an important amendment for scientists across the country who are engaged in ongoing research funded by the National Science Foundation. As everyone in this chamber knows, research and innovation are central to American competitiveness and driving our national economy. Each year, investments in research through NSF help us push the boundaries of scientific knowledge, support new industries, and address the challenges facing our society. I don't think anyone would deny that funding for NSF has overwhelmingly benefited our country. It's also key to our country's continued economic growth. Funding new explorations in science and technology is how we stay on the cutting edge of research. It's how we continue to compete globally in the 21st century economy. That's why I have serious concerns about the implications of the underlying legislation, which needlessly inserts a layer of political review into the scientific research process. To remain a world leader, we need to ensure scientists are exploring transformative new ideas and frontiers based on the merits of their research, not the subjective opinions of politicians in Congress. Unfortunately, those subjective opinions are exactly what's being injected into the process under this legislation. And what's worse, it has the potential to put ongoing research at risk. By changing the rules about how NSF funding is awarded, scientists across the country may rightfully be concerned about how this legislation affects the important work that they're doing today. As someone who started their career in research, I can tell you firsthand, it's incredibly important that you have the certainty to see a project through to the end. Starting and stopping research is highly detrimental. We should provide scientists the long-term visibility to know their ongoing research can be completed without interference from politicians, and that's precisely what my amendment does. My amendment simply clarifies that the underlying legislation does not impact any grant funding that has already been awarded by the NSF. It's critical that we pass it to ensure ongoing research is not disrupted by this unfortunate bill. Mr. Chairman, research isn't a spigot you can turn on and off. I urge my colleagues on both sides of the aisle to support this common sense amendment. And with that, I reserve the balance of my time.
The gentlewoman from Washington reserves. For what purpose does the gentleman from Texas seek recognition?
Mr. Chairman, I claim the time in opposition to the amendment, though I do not oppose the amendment.
Without objection, the gentleman from Texas is recognized for 5 minutes.
Mr. Chairman, I accept the gentlewoman's amendment. It clarifies that the new requirements in the bill do not apply to grants that have already been awarded by the National Science Foundation. I agree that the bill is not intended to be retroactive. In January 2015, NSF began to implement new internal guidelines that promote accountability and transparency. These guidelines are compatible with this bill, but the implementation of them is a work in progress. I will continue to communicate with NSF about how they implement their internal guidelines, but agree that this bill will only apply to future grants once enacted. So, Mr. Chairman, I support the amendment. Yield back the balance of my time.
The gentleman from Texas yields back. The gentlewoman from Washington is recognized.
I want to thank the chairman for his support of the amendment, and I yield back my time.
The gentlewoman from Washington yields back. The question is on the amendment offered by the gentlewoman from Washington. Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed say no. In the opinion of the chair, the ayes have it. The amendment is agreed to.